Hey guys, it's Brandon. As a melodic metal guitarist, I teach you what I've learned through the years and take you on my journey as I continue to grow. So if you're new here and you're into that kind of thing or you just want to hang out, then please subscribe now. Now today let's talk about how to make that leap from the 6-string guitar to the 8-string guitar. Maybe you've been thinking about getting an 8-string, but you've played a 6-string all your life. Now, maybe let's first ask the question, why do you want to go to an 8-string? What's your purpose? Well, just so I can play low notes. Well, awesome, there is a niche for that. You're in for a lot of ridicule if you do go to the 8-string world, but just like anything, you don't care what people says. If you have a specific reason why you want to get an 8-string in the first place, think of that, not just because my friend has one. If you really wanna play lower notes, then hey, that's cool. That's exactly why I got an 8-string. Now, I'll tell you how I made the leap from the 6 to the 8-string. Now, for most of my guitar journey, I have been playing 6-string guitars, and the first time I was ever exposed to a 7-string was on YouTube. And so then I went into a guitar shop in my local area, and so I sat down and I'd play, and I was like, wow, this neck is a little bit larger than a 6-string. This feels kind of weird, but the more and more that I played it, the more and more I got used to it. And at that same guitar shop, they eventually had an 8-string for sale.
I will never own an 8-string. There is no way. This neck is too huge,
says the man who has an 8-string now. Now, this didn't happen overnight, consistently playing the 7-strings as I went into the shop. So having gotten used to the 7-string after so many years, the 8-string wasn't a big of a leap as it was before. So I guess my point in all of this is make it a slow transition. If you're going to get an 8-string and you're only used to ever playing a 6-string, I beg you, just get a 7-string to start out with. I was doing the stereotypical chug, chug, chug all the time. After a while, that gets boring unless maybe you can do it right with like other ambient stuff going on in the background. But these days, I actually play this guitar like a 7-string, and I use that 8-string every now and then. And that I find a whole lot better than just using the 8-string, because that is where all the ridicule comes from, is from the 6-string guitar players believe that the 8-string players are all the same, that all they want out of the guitar is to do the heavy metal distorted chug chug stuff. There are a lot of players, such as we're talking Animals as Leaders and such like that, that will use clean tones. And then, you know, you've got Rob Scallion who does a lot of tapping and stuff as well. And he's playing all these other intricate notes and stuff. So to recap, if you're going to switch to an 8-string, make it a gradual change, maybe get a 7-string for a while, or maybe do what I did, practice and practice on the 7-strings until you're absolutely comfortable. Try out the 8-string, get comfortable with that too before you go ahead and just go all out and just hit the 8-string. Okay guys, so I hope that you enjoyed today's video. Thank you so much for listening, and subscribe for more weekly content. I post Wednesdays and Saturdays videos like this, or sometimes we'll do musical compositions. I'll sometimes do vocal covers. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a great weekend.